What's up, y'all? It's your boy RJ Powell. We are back with another deep conversation video for you today. Today we're going to be talking about Instagram getting rid of their likes and views. They're basically getting rid of the numbers and trying to let followers just connect through photos and videos. Instagram released a statement saying that they just want friends and family and Instagram users to just focus on the photos and videos rather than focus on the likes, how many likes you get, how many views you get on a video. It's a way to cut down the problem of mental health in the social media world, because we know in this generation, the mental health problem is heavy in social media. Everybody feels like they gotta be on top. Everybody feel like when they see this type of picture, they gotta be like, oh, I gotta do something better. Everybody is doing it for clout. It's all a competition now. Like my guy V Rob said in his video, it's all a competition. Everybody feels like they gotta be better than everybody else, which is not the case. I don't see why it's a competition between all of us, bro. Like Instagram platforms like that, it's supposed to be used for change. It's supposed to be used for speaking and expressing your feelings through photos, through videos. I don't get why it's a competition between everybody within this generation in the social media realm. And Instagram is trying to change all of that. They're trying to get rid of the numbers and just focus on the people and themselves, the photos, the videos, the messaging themselves. And I really like this direction Instagram is going if they do get rid of all of the numbers, all of the likes and views and stuff like that. I really hope that they run a big test in the USA as well, because I know it is an avid problem through the USA as well. This generation, they need something like that. They need to just focus on the photos and videos. No matter how you feel about it, it will help a great deal with people dealing with these problems, because people feel like they're worthless when they see somebody that had probably like a six pack of abs. They feel bad for the girl who has, you know, the quote-unquote perfect body, or when people are flexing with their Lambos and mansions and stuff, people feel like they're not good enough in life. And people just want to show the best version of themselves in social media rather than show, you know, all stages of themselves. You know, it's a rare group of people that actually show their best version to their lowest point. I try to show myself to my lowest point, maybe to my best self. I don't try to flex or nothing, because I know I ain't got that. If you know you ain't got that, why are you flexing and stuff like that? But Instagram, they're trying to fix the problem. Like I said, they're running tests in Brazil, Australia, Japan, and like three more other countries as well. And I have some data on this. It said, yet many teams also report feeling pressure to always show the best versions of themselves. That's 15% of teams. And then the overload with information. This is the informational age. We're getting information from left and right. We don't even know if it's real or not. We don't even know if anything is real as far as information. And 10% says they're having an overload with information. 9% are feeling overwhelmed by it. You know, if you follow even like 50 people, you get overwhelmed by how many posts they're posting. You're just hit with so many different photos, so many different videos, and that's just unhealthy. Sometimes we need to unwind down and just take a break from social media, just get offline for a second, and just take a walk in nature or the park or something like that, just to clear our mind. Because I feel like when we are on social media, we feel like it's FOMO, the fear of missing out. So we're constantly checking, oh, what did this happen? Did this happen? Where did they go? What's happening? We're in that digital age where we feel like we have to know every single thing that's going on, whether it's a music festival, whether it's an NBA game, whether it's a fashion show. We feel like we have to know every single thing that's going on. And when you're on social media, not everything is important. Like 90% of the things you see on your timeline is not really important. Like, if we're being real, it's not really important. Like, the fear of missing out is just a mental thing. Like, we think things that are not that important are really important. That's what social media does to us. It programs us to think those types of things. And moving on with the stats, so to say, the fear of missing out, 9% feel FOMO. 9% feel FOMO. And that's that just breaks my heart, because as the years go on, kids that are younger and younger are now getting on social media. You see 5-year-olds on social media now. You see even maybe 3-year-olds. You see babies on social media now. So they're starting off when they come straight from the womb in social media. Now, I'm not saying social media is a bad thing, because I'm an avid user of social media. If you count YouTube as a social media, yeah, I use that. Instagram, I'm on that. Twitter, I'm on that. Anything else, though, I'm probably not on that. I'm mainly on Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube, if you count that as a social media platform. But I think that Instagram, they're doing a great thing. Now, the people that is going to hurt, that Instagram is taking away the likes and views, it's going to hurt sponsors. It's going to hurt influencers. It's going to hurt corporate businesses, because they're looking for the next big thing. And so by not having the likes and views, we don't know. We don't know if they're big or not. We don't know if, you know, they have 1 million views or 1 million likes on this photo. We would never know. So that's going to hurt sponsors for looking out for new talent. But I think it's a great thing. I think it's just going to focus on the individuals themselves rather than focus on likes. Because when sponsorships are coming to you, they're, of course, a select few of corporate sponsors or whatever, they're looking for the individuals, they're looking for their personalities. But most oftentimes, they're looking for, okay, this person has 1 million followers, 1 million views or whatever, so we're probably going to look out for them to, you know, promote our brand because they have a huge following. Folks like LeBron, folks like the Kardashians, Kim Kardashian, Kylie Jenner, or the Selena Gomez of the world, you know what I'm saying? They're looking for people like that. And so that's going to hurt them. They're going to hurt influencers who have millions of followers. And so we would never know if, we would probably never know if something is going to get viral now on Instagram. Many people they said they might leave off of Instagram. I don't know if that's true or not, but many users said they might leave off of Instagram or may take a break from Instagram and may look elsewhere. But Instagram, if you think about it, that's probably the only platform where you could speak through photos. And I think it's probably the best social media platform you could have to make change and express yourself through photos and videos. Of course, Twitter, you could express yourself through words, through videos as well, through photos as well. But Instagram is more of a photo-based platform to do all that. And so Instagram, by taking away the likes and views, I think is a great thing for us. Let me know what you think about Instagram taking away the views and likes. I think it is a step in the right direction of these folks going through mental health problems. I think it would help a great bevy of those going through anxiety and stuff like that. So hopefully they would take it away by the end of, probably by the beginning of next year. I think it would be a great help for our generation, and it would really open up our eyes to what's in front of us, y'all. It's your boy RJ Powell. Take care. Stay off of social media for a little bit. I challenge y'all to stay half of the day off of social media, y'all, because it is very important. Our mental health is very important. I hope you take care of yourself, guys. It's your boy RJ Powell. We out, baby.